Hello viewers, this is Elimu TV, a station where you get to watch and learn. Welcome to our history class, and today we are getting to look at Form 1, our first lesson on sources of information on history and government. Now that we know what history is, right, can we now get to look at how did we get the sources of information, or rather how did we get information on history and government? Now, as always, it is your tutor, Rajab Michira. By the end of the lesson class, what we expect to have known at the end of the discussion, we need to state some of the sources of information on history and government, and also get to state the advantages and limitations of the sources of information on history and government. Now, straight to our today's lesson, we are looking at sources of information on history and government. And as we know, we have got three sources of information on history and government. One, we have the unwritten source. Two, we have the written source. Then three, we have the electronic source. So as we'll be moving along, we'll be getting to look at each and every source of history and government. So can we get to start from oral tradition, unwritten source. So unwritten source, this refers to historical information that was not recorded, right? The prehistory. And as you know, prehistory is the history that was not recorded. Now unwritten source, this is the historical information which was not recorded. And we have got various types, or we've got various examples of unwritten source of history and government. One, we have got oral tradition. Two, we have got linguistic. Three, we have got anthropology. Four, we have got archaeology. And lastly, we have genetics. Now, as we'll be moving along, we'll be getting to look at each and every example of the unwritten source. But for today's class, learners, can we get to look at what this oral tradition is? Oral tradition. Now, oral tradition basically refers to the passing of information by a word of mouth. And mostly, this is the earliest form of, this is the earliest source of information on history and government. Now, from the word oral, it is simply passing by word of mouth. Now, as you can see in our image there, we have got one person seated on a higher place, right? On a higher stone as compared to others. Then there are those others who are seated below the person, right? Now, the one who is seated above them seems like he's narrating something. He's narrating a certain story, narrating a certain event, right? Now, as you can clearly see, information is being passed by word of mouth. That is basically what we call oral tradition, right? And this was very common in the traditional society, whereby the younger people would sit, right, with the elderly people. For example, the grandparents, right? The grandparents would always narrate information, would always narrate what they know, right? What, how they used to conduct their things, right? The past events, they could narrate to the young ones. So that method of passing information by word of mouth is what we call oral tradition. However, we had advantages of oral tradition. For example, it is important in the study of prehistory, and we cannot learn prehistory. Prehistory, this is the unrecorded history, and recorded history can only be transmitted by word of mouth. So it is an important way of studying prehistory. And also, they integrate the study of history and other social sciences. For example, communication, right? Through oral tradition, we could know how to communicate. We could know how to pass information. And lastly, it is cheap. The only thing it needs is your time. Just sit and listen how things were done in the prehistory. So it is a cheap method of obtaining information on history and government. Having looked at the advantages of oral tradition, I want us to look at the limitations. What are some of the disadvantages of oral tradition? For example, the information may be forgotten. How can it be forgotten? Remember, however is narrating the information is a person, and we have good memory, right? Sometimes memory can be lost. you cannot get the correct chronological events on how things happened from the first point to the last point. So sometimes information can be forgotten or omitted. And lastly, information may deliberately conceal some important information, meaning someone can deliberately conceal some information. And mostly, when I'm telling, for example, I'm the one narrating something, right? And maybe that information was about me. So I will only give the positive events of what I'm narrating. So one would only give those events that favor the person. So in that case, information can be deliberately be concealed. Now, learners, as always, we have an assignment, and that is an assignment that I really want people to try out and get to look at more of the advantages and the disadvantages of oral tradition. And in this assignment, I wish that you get resource people, right? Go to your grandparents if they are there, or go to the elder people in the society and let them also tell you some of the advantages and disadvantages of oral tradition as a source of information on history and government. And using our reference material, can we get to use Evolving World History Form 2, which is the 6th edition? Remember, we have got a number of editions, but I will also advise that let us use the latest edition, which is the 6th edition. And this has been your favorite learning channel, a station where you watch and learn, which is Elimu TV. You can contact us always via our Facebook page, which is Elimu TV, our Twitter account, which is Elimu_TV_Kenya, and you can also send us a message via our number, which is 0723 144 259. Let us get in touch. Let us keep Elimu TV where we watch and learn.